So here we are. It's Celebrity Saturday. The cavalcade of stars has begun at the Provincetown Film Festival 2014. And here with one of my favorite stars, Nigel.
Hello.
No, you used to think I didn't like you, but...
What are you talking about?
Yeah. Oh, we used to meet all the time and you said, do you know who I used to say? Or do you know who I am?
Well, I didn't say that.
No, you didn't. It's like, don't you know who I am? How are you, darling?
I'm good.
You got your Bloody Mary. You're all ready to go.
Yeah.
It's a grueling round of interviews,
it's
of
tough.
Which this may be the only one.
Yeah, probably.
You're covering this, of course, for IndieWire.
I am. I'm supposed to be talking to John Waters shortly about his book, Carsick. You read it?
No, but I filmed the book signing.
Oh.
In which you couldn't see him because he was inside signing, but I got everybody on the line.
Yeah.
I got people outside the store. I got all the signs.
Was there a big line?
Yes, and it kept going and going and going, and it was like, if you wanted to see him, you had to buy the book.
How much was it going for?
$26,
wow.
But they just sent one to my home in New York, so I'll read it when I get home.
Mm. I bought it on iTunes, so, or iBook, I don't know what you call it.
Is an iTunes thing to do with cartoons? No.
That's something. iTunes, Apple.
Oh, all right. Well, we'll have to explain that. You have to explain that to me. I'm so tongue-tied.
Yeah.
So, anything you've seen? Experiences?
Seen, yes. Experience? Well, I've experienced this beautiful scenery you see behind you. It's gorgeous here.
Nigel owns all of it. He's very quiet about it.
Yeah.
Very discreet.
Very discreet. I just got in yesterday, so unfortunately I haven't been to.
But you've seen some of the
any screenings yet? But I've seen some of the films that are playing here.
And what have you seen that you liked?
Well, I have seen what's playing. There's so much playing.
There's
you know,
a
the festival
lot.
Lineup's really big this year.
Well, I liked Hard Day's Night.
Oh, I haven't seen that, but I did see The Case Against Abe. I know that's
I haven't seen
yesterday.
That.
Yeah.
Let's talk about that.
It's really great.
What is eight who?
You know, the case
it's against Prop A.
Prop A,
okay.
Yeah.
The law was banning gay marriage in California, is that correct?
Yeah, but the two filmmakers, tracked the case for however many years it went on for. I think it went on for 5 years, the entire ordeal, from the initial... But they tracked the story for 5 years, up until the Supreme Court decision that, overturned Prop 8 in California. So the film itself is pretty remarkable, just given the fact that they were there from day one in this case, all up until, way up until, its final decision.
Yes, you see the different films that I've seen.
Yeah. Well, that played at Sundance, and it's played at several festivals. I think it's already come out in New York.
I think so, yes.
Yeah. But it's screened here, and I think it'll end up pretty well. So that's a good one. I've heard really great things about Love is Strange, Iris Sachs' new movie.
Yeah. I'll tell you about that. Yeah.
Well, I haven't seen it yet, but
I haven't
Sundance,
either.
And it comes out, I think, later this summer.
What's it about?
It's it stars Alfred Molina.
Oh, yes, that's tomorrow
Jonathan
night.
Lithgow.
Tomorrow night, yes.
Yeah, no, it's tonight.
Oh, it's tonight.
At the Town Hall. I think it's 7, after the John Waters David Cronenberg talk. And they play a couple that gets married. I think they've been together for, 20 or so years. And they're not doing so well financially, so I think they have to move out of their house and are forced to live separately for the first time in a number of years. And I think it's about their struggle to, keep their relationship strong while, I think one lives with his daughter while the other lives with somebody else. And it's supposed to be really touching.
So, have you ever been to one of these filmmakers, John Waters versus a filmmaker?
Yeah, I went last year.
What did they like?
Last year was great. Oh, you should have gone last year. Last year was between John Waters and Harmony Korine.
Oh, that must have been something.
Yeah, because, those two filmmakers are kind of similar in their...
edginess.
Their taste for the edginess. But it was great. It was a lot of fun. John Waters is clearly a fan of everything Korine.
Okay.
So the two of them got along swimmingly, and, Harmony is kind of a shy guy for the most part.
Oh, is he really?
Well, yeah, from what I've seen in public appearances, but with Johnny, he was totally at ease. And it was great. It was awesome.
Yeah, people walking around, since we're still talking about John Waters, with books of Carsick, you'll see it all over town.
Yeah.
People are cradling it in their arms.
Well, people love him here.
I think he's the mayor, but they just don't want people to.
Right?
It's like,
well, Provincetown, I read most of the book, his new book, Carsick, and it makes an appearance several times because he talks about wanting to, because you know what it's about. It's about this road trip he goes on from his home in Baltimore
to
a co-op he, I think, owns in
San Francisco.
And
he's hitchhiking. It's about hitchhiking.
Yeah, yeah. And he meets some crazy characters along the way. But half of the book is fictional. Actually, three quarters of the book is fictional.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah, it starts out with a whole section about what could happen. The best case scenario.
Okay.
So he meets, you know, lovely people. They all know who he is. They all treat him like a celebrity. Life is great. And then there's a whole section of the book dedicated to the worst that could happen.
Okay.
And, you know, most of the people that pick him up don't know who he is, are homophobic. And then he eventually, well, I don't want to give away the ending of the fictional.
I guess he gets to San Francisco.
Well,
he's back.
Not in the worst case scenario.
Oh, okay.
But, yeah.
And I hear Peter has a film here.
He does. He has a short film here.
Peter Connect.
Yeah, it's his
Our
first
short
film.
Our short friend has a short film.
He directed it, he wrote it, and he stars in it.
No kidding.
Yeah.
So I bet, I hope he comes today.
Yeah.
To talk
Actually,
about
he was
it.
In What's a movie before.
What was
I Want Your Love by Travis Matthews, I think is his name. He directed the that movie with James Franco recently,
What's
Interior
the name
Leather
of
Bar. His short movie's called, I don't know, I should know the title. It's but I've seen it and it's great.
What is it about?
It's about Peter recently just turned 30, sorry. But the film's about a 30-year-old waking up one morning to realize that he hooked up the night prior with a young twink.
Oh.
And so it's about him just kind of coming to terms
he's
with
no longer the young twin.
His age. And
he looks so fabulous. And now he's going to be doing the Oscar thing with Ann Thompson, our beloved Ann Thompson.
And do a podcast during the award season, I think every week.
Oscar talk. Yeah, I ran into Mark Harris, you know, who lives here with his lover,
Kushner.
And Mark is another great Oscarologist. Mm-hmm. And
they know each other, those two. Peter and
Mark.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, Mark's delightful. And so is Peter. So I said to Mark, you know, what's the story? And what's the Oscar story? And he says, not until the fall.
Oh, wow.
He goes, not until the fall.
Leave me alone.
Yeah.
Well, hey, I mean, the season already kind of kicked off with Sundance, right? I mean,
yeah,
no rest.
At Edwards Daily, shout out to Sasha Stone. After all these years, she and I are still doing stuff together on Oscars all year long. And what's your take on The Fault in Our Stars?
I know that Peter put it in his like top five of films that could be nominated for Best Picture.
Best Actress.
That's the first I read of that.
I think she
has a good chance at being nominated.
She could even win.
Well, I don't know about
that. She's 21.
Yeah, but I don't think the film's not a critical darling.
But her performance is impeccable.
Great. Yeah.
You haven't seen it?
No, I've seen
it.
Oh,
you've seen
it? I loved it. I was a mess. She had to wipe me off the floor at the end of the movie. But I don't think it's a great movie. I think she's very strong in it.
Okay.
But I don't know if a lot of adults take that film seriously, especially when it comes to
that subject.
Awards talk. I mean, it's based on a teen novel, you know, skews to that demographic. But I think it's a really good film. I don't think it's going to go.
And it's successful.
The distance. It's super successful, yeah. I mean, especially that first week when all the books came out.
And it's about cancer and death. And
you know who I think has the best chance of winning is Laura Dern, who plays her mother in the film.
For supporting, perhaps.
Because she does so much with the role that's pretty underrated.
Talking about Laura Dern, her father drives me crazy. I mean, if he had put himself in the supporting category, if he'd allowed himself
you
this
think
past
so?
Year, he would have won.
But that wasn't a supporting performance.
No, but he would have won over
But his wasn't his
Jared Leto.
The other guy nominated? The guy who played his son?
No.
Are you sure?
No.
Yes, he was.
Not for the Oscars, he wasn't.
Oh, you're right. Okay, well, he was nominated for the...
He would have won over Jared Leto, the transvestite drug addict in...
Well, that would have been great. I would have seen, like, just
I could
anybody
have totally
win over him.
In
Dallas
Buyers Club, yeah. Okay, we're both on margarita time, although I'm
but
not.
But one film
I'm
that
just
I've,
drinking water, yeah.
That's, you know, kind of stirred a little awards talk is a film that we just were discussing, Love is Strange.
Oh, I can't wait.
I think that's one of the ones that screened at Sundance. That,
well,
I mean, Sony Classics bought it, so that's already a first.
Oh, okay.
first Clue, but I've heard nothing but great things about that film, so that could be, you know, part of the discussion come the fall.
And what did you see?
Pancakes Against Date for Best Documentary. HBO picked it up.
Critics
love it. Audiences love it. I did a talk at the Academy for that film, so I know that the Academy's
into it.
Screening that film, so that could go all
And
the way.
They all live in California, so.
Yeah.
And today, later on, we are going to be interviewing, and I hope I am too.
Who?
David Cronenberg.
Oh, yeah.
And Deborah Winger is supposed to be.
Yeah, yeah. David's great. I talked to McCann about his new movie.
Oh, yeah, which is
called... Have you seen it?
What is it?
Maps to the Stars?
To the Stars, not For the Stars.
No, I think it's two. Which is
and
great.
And you saw that?
Yeah.
Oh, tell us about that, because I haven't seen it.
I think it's only screened at Cannes. I don't know if it's screened anywhere else, but it's a Hollywood satire. It's very dark.
It
kind of harks back to his earlier dark work, like Crash. And
David Cronenberg did Crash? No, that was David Haggis.
No! Oh, I'm talking about the good Crash.
Oh.
There's two Crash movies.
Oh, there's two Crash.
One won Best Picture, and one screen at Cannes is known for a scene where a woman gets penetrated in her leg by a man. That's David Cronenberg.
That Crash, yes.
Yeah, that's the good Crash. He directed that. Kind of harks back to that. It's pretty extreme.
Elias Kotrias, right?
What's that?
Elias.
Yeah,
Kotrias.
Holly Hunter.
Yeah.
But this new one's great. It stars
Julianne Moore. And
Julianne Moore.
She's getting a lot of Oscar buzz.
She's definitely going to get nominated, I think, in the supporting category, even though she won Best Actress at Cannes. Surprisingly, I thought she deserved it, but people were kind of up in arms over it.
So, was that supposed to open in June and then it got pushed to the fall? Or
I don't think so. I think it's still coming out
the fall.
Soon. I don't know. Is it coming out in the fall?
I know it's in award season now, so that must mean it's distributors think
oh, I don't,
of it to
I
keep it till then.
Yeah, but E1 is distributing it, so I can't really
see it going.
So, and
what do they
going.
Know? They know
Sorry.
What they're doing.
Yeah, yeah, I don't know. Who knows? I don't see it going that far. Well, I see her performance getting a lot of
The first question somebody from the industry asked me up here is, what did I think about Fault in Our Stars?
Really?
That was the first question I got asked. So
wow.
I said I loved her, but the film not so much.
No? Did you cry?
No, I'm too old to cry at movies about death.
Oh.
I've heard the chimes at midnight, and it ain't pretty, honey. Anyway, on that happy note, I think we've talked about just about all we could talk about.
Yeah.
Thank you for summing everything up
so
beautifully, the beautiful Nigel Smith. I love your post. I'm glad we're Facebook friends, so.
Of course.
I know everything. And so do you, actually. All right, thanks, honey.
Thank you.